Just for the record, I and I, faithful and truth, Rastafari, yes, we accept His Imperial Majesty, Ked Maui, Haile Selassie, King of Kings, Elect of God, Conquering Lion of the Tribe of Judah, Emperor of Ethiopia, Earth's Rightful Ruler, yes, He is I and I, God and Father. Now don't get carried away, because what is God? You know? And so, and all authority in Rastafari is in fact derived and granted in and through even Christ, you know, Jesus, Jesus Christos, even Yehoshua HaMashiach, you know, Yeshua HaMashiach, and yes, just for the record, and so that being stated, shalom and greetings to Na Yesteling. I am Alon Koneteferi Alonzo of Rastafari Fellowship, and addressing the question, is Rastafari a religion? And of course, the answer is yes. In fact, it is a religion. Rastafari is a religion, and of the highest and most purest form. And all other religions would do good to remember, and if thou cannot remember, then research, study, investigate the matter thoroughly. Not only do I encourage, you know, Muslims and Jews and Christians, Catholics, you know, atheists, so on and so forth, not only do I encourage those people to investigate the matter, I challenge these people, all the peoples of the world, to challenge the authority, you know, that is Rastafari, you know, Rastafari, I and I Godfather. And inevitably you will conclude to the only conclusion possible. First let me address that. This is only to those who are true in seeking truth. Those who truly seek a true faith. And you know, because if you are those that are of a hardened heart, that and have no ears to hear, no eyes to see, so on and so forth, and just want to make believe whatever whatever thou wishest to make believe, then no, I am not speaking to those people. Even the fanatics, you know. To the real Christians, real Catholics, real Jews, real Muslims that aren't trying to fight, just like I and I is not trying to pick a fight, you know, declaring the truth of Rastafari. I and I is just trying to set the record straight. Yes, Rastafari is a religion, and all other religions would do good to remember that, in fact, all other religions are under the authority of Rastafari. And I challenge all to prove otherwise, you know. And before anyone's get carried away, no, it doesn't mean that all other peoples are slaves to Rastafari. No, you know, the fact that all religions are under the authority of Rastafari is significant in the way that children of Rastafari only bear a higher responsibility of pretty much the way of living correctly in the righteousness that is Jesus Christos. And so, no, it's not to say that I and I is better, or that I and I is to rule over. Well, you know, let's not get into details. Let's stick to the matter. But, you know, as a higher authority, I and I is to act out and live a living higher morality. And so don't get offended by the fact that Rastafari, in fact, is of a higher authority, for all the world was granted to the, you know, to the kings, to the Negush of Ethiopia, you know. And so, you know, if people think that just smoking and colors and hair make a Rasta, well, yeah, they do make a Rasta, but Rastafari, the truth, is written in the Kebra, K Kibra Nekesh, you know? And so go read that. You know, the Queen of Sheba and her only son Menelik, the union of King Solomon of Jerusalem and Queen Makeda of Ethiopia. And so, you know, check that out. Do your research. And I is not picking a fight. We just, you know, just let truth be truth. And well, the matter of Muslims, speaking to Muslims, you know, in a positive sense, Muslims or the Nation of Islam would do good to remember that in times of persecution, when Muslim peoples were, you know, pretty much kicked out of Mecca or had to flee Mecca, and this is not to insult anyone. We've all have our persecutions, even to this very day, for, you know, this wicked world and worldly beings within it. They hate the righteousness that is Yehoshua HaMashiach. You know, not us. You know, just to state that for the record as well. Ayanda is as a dirty rag. The only good we can bring to the table. The only good offering is Jesus Christos even, you know? And so, you know, Muslims would do good to remember when thou fleddest out of Mecca, thou sought and set out in search for a righteous king that would do no wrong to innocent peoples. And so, you know, the Nation of Islam, Muslims, ended up traveling to Ethiopia, you know, Aksum at that time. And you know, and pled their case, their plea to the king, to the Negus of Ethiopia of Aksum, of the Aksum Empire at that time. And you know, our ancestral king accepted the Muslim people, sheltered them, and even settled them in the area that is now known as the Tigray region. And interesting, that's not even the center for Muslim culture. That would be Harar, you know, Harar. And so, but anyways, sticking to the matter, you know, those that were persecuting Islam sent emissaries to the king, Aksumite king, to ask for those individuals, you know, probably just to kill them. But our king refused, you know. And so Muslims would do even better to recall and remember, bring to the remembrance that the Prophet Muhammad, he instructed his followers, true and faithful, to, you know, to keep peace with the Christian people of Ethiopia and to protect Aksum. And so, you know, that's just a little bit of history of the relationship, the real and true relationship of Ayandai as Rastafari and the Nation of Islam. Now, addressing Catholics and Christians, you know, it's not to offend anyone, but Christianos, Christians, you would do good to remember that all of your sects, all of the thousands and thousands of different kinds of Christianity, all derived from the Catholic Church, pretty much. It all happened during the Lutheran, you know, the rebellion, and the Protestant Reformation, it is called. And so, even within Ayandai's selves, you know, Christians stop dissing on, disrespecting on Catholics. You know, you're a part. You all bow to the same, you know, master, I guess. And it's not even Yehoshua. It's not even Jesus Christos. It's the Vatican Pope and his councils, you know? And so, and this isn't to offend the true and faithful, you know, because it's not your fault that the higher authorities have done as horrible as they have, but you do play a part of it by not, you know, seeking truth. And so just keep in mind that if you all respond to the see or the papal see, the seat, which they want to make pretend it is the see of Peter, well, you know, so be it. You know, Hollywood makes different kinds of movies all the time too. So yeah, let the papal see pretend to be that which they were never intended to be and will never be. And so, you know, proceeding, if the papal or the Vatican controls pretty much, and this isn't to raise speculation on who controls the world. Of course, it is Jah Rastafari, you know, the Almighty Creator that give guidance and protection to all his children, the children of Rastafari, the children of Israel, even, you know, the tribe of Judah, the Afro-Shemitic peoples of the world and company. And so if the Vatican has a lot of authority in this present world, if you want to call it that, seclorum, then look around. The world is shattering into pieces. So that gives you an idea of what kind of fruit the Vatican tree is bearing at this season, at this due season. And so, you know, and it's to say Catholics and Christians, you know, give His Majesty a try, you know, try every spirit, and he who comes and testifies that Jesus is the Son of God and came in the flesh, he is of God, and that is exactly our God and Father, you know. And so he loved his son so much, he all glory is to his son, Yehoshua HaMashiach. And so, well, the whole point of that discussion is that that the state of Rome was originally Constantinople, but as also it is written in the Quebra Negest, is how there would be a separation and how wicked ones would do their own thing, and you can see that fulfilled in the Vatican doing what they're not doing God's work, you know. But you know it. Originally, the Kingdom of Rome, and still is under the authority of the King of Ethiopia. So, you know, long story short, I should have just said that. You know, apologize, but although there is no need, I seek not to offend, you know, anyone of any religion, for that is the will of I and thy Father, to respect everyone's, you know, beliefs and religion systems and so on and so forth. But it was important to declare, you know. So anyways, all Christian, all Catholic are pretty much under the jurisdiction of the King of Ethiopia. And well, before I go on to the following, let me first just clarify that ones would might be thinking, then what does Rastafari have to do with jurisdiction that is the sovereignty of the King of Ethiopia? Well, Rastafari is the emperor, not only the king, he's the king of kings, he's the emperor of Ethiopia, you know, descended from Solomon and Sheba, you know, carrying on that long legacy and lineage of the Afro-Shemitic peoples of the world and how all originated in Africa. And so that's to say that our father, and coincidentally enough, it was in a Christmas special of Oswald or Osmond, Forgive I for not recalling his name, but the interviewer, the Lutheran Hour's Christmas special interview with His Imperial Majesty, Kedemawi, Haile Selassie Negusha Negest, Soyume Igazi Abher, Moa Ambesa Ze Emnegera Yehuda Ze Ethiopia. Well, in that interview, being that His Majesty responded in the official language that is the Amharic of the official Ethiopian language, being that it's the official language of the kingdom, all official business is held in the official language. So the fact that our father responded in the Amharic, then it means that the following is official. It made it official. And so His Majesty answers one question by stating that all those to that pertain to his nation, him being emperor over that nation, are those who follow, seek, and do the will of Yehoshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christos, that follows the Ten Commandments, and so and not only the Ten Commandments, that keep covenant, but that follow the commandments of the Father as well as the Son, for they both came to testify to the same law. And so those that keep and do the commandments that are written in the scriptures, that those are his nation, and that not only would we be historically Christian, but also presently and living Christian, living, walking in the living faith with the living God and our living brother, the son of our living father. And so, that's clear. So basically, the nation of Ethiopia and company, because to Jacob would be given a nation and a company of nations, and so that is Ethiopia, and it's all over the Bible. It just takes a different outlook. His Majesty clearly directed I and I in the ultimate challenge speech, addressing I believe it was addressing the United Nations in New York. He addressed on how we have to be something that we have never been. More courageous, ampler in our cloak, and greater in outlook. So, look at things from a greater sight, from a greater perspective, and inevitably you will result to the same conclusion that is that the kingdom of Ethiopia is the inheritor of the world and of the world to come and of the world everlasting, and so the kingdom of Jah Rastafari. And so without getting off track, next are the Jews, whether it be Sephardic, Ashkenazi, all, I don't want to bring color, but or culture, but yes, all Caucasian Jews, Polish, Germanic, Hungarian and Russian, at best, most of them are converts. And it's not to offend anyone. Truth be truth. But to the Jewish population, basically addressing the Jewish population, I and I is not seeking to discriminate. 'Cause if you keep and you know what, let me just declare that, you of all people should know. You do a good job of and I'm talking to the faithful, not to the Zionist and not to the extremist and not to the to the humble families and people, children, women, fathers, mothers, daughters, everything, all them that truly seek to just live the healthy lifestyle that is the, you know, the Hebraic Christian way of life. And so addressing the matter that you of all people should know, you know the scriptures, and especially you know the Old Testament, and you would do good to remember that the house of Israel does not reflect the history of your people. And that's a fact, you know, accept it. And you know scripture, you know exactly who the house of Israel is. And it's not white people. I'm sorry to say it like that, but it's not the Caucasian Jews. And don't get offended, it's just truth. Thou has not fulfilled scripture as has the true and real house of Israel, the Afro-Shemitic peoples of the world. Now, continuing, also have to address the matter that Jews are separated within themselves, and so I'm only speaking to those that accept the Mashiach, you know, Jesus Christos, Yehoshua, Yeshua, you know, because you would better understand those that don't accept him, really don't pertain to this conversation. And so, you know, and so basically, oh well, to conclude, atheist, I really don't have anything to say to atheist or anyone who doesn't believe in the truth of the Almighty Creator that is good, because I'm not here to be and serve as a pillar to those who cannot sustain themselves, who cannot support their own roof, because they have no roof, they have no house, no belief, no nothing. And so, you know, just food for thought, you know, to all those that do not accept the divinity of the Almighty Creator, and that all is within His creation, and His creation being all, then all being one in His creation. And so it's, you know, I'm calling to all the religions and peoples of the world that Rastafari is truth, is of a higher authority, and challenges you to seek the matter, find truth for thyself, study and show yourselves approved, you know, to be workmen, need not be ashamed, rightfully dividing the word of truth. And that, you know, our Father taught us and the whole world, well, those who would listen, that it's time to owe allegiance, not to nations, groups, sects, religions, you know, corporations, etc., but rather to swear our allegiance to the best interest of the human race. What is best and what is good for the human community? Forget governments and nations and so on and so forth. What is good for the survival of humankind? Humans in the image of God, not beastly creatures. You know, Jah gave us reasoning and intellect to sort things out, to resolve disputes in civilized manner, not barbaric means of war, and so on and so forth. So, you know, give that a thought. You know, Shalom, give thanks for your time. I apologize on behalf of all those who have presented the image, well, the interpretation of a Rastafari, but were not. There are few, but we will make ourselves shown in order that our God and Father might be glorified, and inevitably glorification all being to the Son, to His Son, Yehoshua HaMashiach, Jesus Christos. You know, I apologize for all those that have encountered, you know, unrespectable Rastas, you know, that have the hair and hear the music and wear the clothes and the colors. But that's not in truth Rastafari. In truth, we keep the dietary laws, follow the commandments, seek to walk in the way of Christ, seek to do good to our brothers and sisters of the world within the human community. We seek peace. We don't seek to disrespect people. We don't just seek to, you know, yeah, we seek to chant songs of praise to our God and Father in and through His Son. But it's not that image that's been portrayed of drug trafficking, tangled hair, you know, individuals that listen to reggae. That's not Rastafari. And Rastafari is a religion, in fact, and in truth, and in spirit. And respect it because it is of a higher authority, and all other peoples of the world are under the authority of the King of Ethiopia via, you know, I mean, resulting in authority of Rastafari over the world, for this earth is the footstool of our God and Father, and Zion, heaven, is his throne. Shalom, Rastafari. Oh, let me just include that before, you know, my bad, that, some people might be thinking that, oh, well, you, Alonso, did not have the courage to, show your face. That's not the case, you know. Go to Rastafari Fellowship, and I do show my face, and I've given my address and my phone number, and, you know, Calexico, California, that's where I live, you know. 1017 Horizon Street, write it down. I fear no one, you know, come and get me. You know, if everyone knows where I'm at, you know, the system, whatever, governments know where I'm at. Come and get I fear not at all. And so that's not the matter. That's not the deal. I just happen not to be able to do this in a visual form. And so I'll put a picture of I just to set the record straight. This isn't I'm not trying to hide I and die face, you know. So give thanks for your time. Shalom, Rastafari.